I'm not ashamed.
Why did the chief priests and scribes not want Jesus killed during the feast days? This is the question that we seek to answer today as we continue our verse-by-verse study of the book of Matthew on walking through the Bible.
The glory of his cross.
If you have a Bible with you, you can turn to Matthew chapter 26. We're going to be reading from verses 1 to 5. If you don't have a Bible, don't worry. Just follow along with us on the screen. The version that we'll be reading from is the New King James Version. So, Matthew chapter 26, beginning at verse 1. Now it came to pass when Jesus had finished all these sayings that he said to his disciples, "You know that after 2 days is the Passover, and the Son of Man will be delivered up to be crucified." Then the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders of the people assembled at the palace of the high priest, who is called Caiaphas, and plotted to take Jesus by trickery and kill him. But they said, "Not during the feast, lest there be an uproar among the people." Jesus has spent the last two chapters explaining to the disciples about the destruction of Jerusalem and its temple, as well as his second coming. These two events are separate, a point that we need to constantly be reminded of. For his destruction of the destruction of Jerusalem, we refer you to Matthew chapter 24, verses 1 to 35, lessons 117 to 120 in this series. Starting in verse 36 of Matthew 24, all the way through the entirety of chapter 25, we have Jesus teaching about his second coming. His disciples were told there would be no signs to look for this event. Therefore, they would always be ready. He spoke two parables to explain this concept, the parable of the 10 virgins and the parable of the talents. He then gave the disciples a picture of judgment, where the righteous and the wicked would be separated, judged according to their obedience to the word of God, with the righteous receiving eternal life, while the wicked would receive eternal punishment. This brings us to chapter 26, with Jesus finishing his teachings of the last two chapters. The rest of this book, with the exception of the last 5 verses in chapter 28, take place in a period of 5 days. Now it is important to note that the Jews calculate time differently to the Romans and differently than we do today. The Romans and us calculate time from midnight to midnight, while the Jews calculate time from sunset to sunset. That is why Genesis 1 counts the days, and the evening and the morning was a certain day. Since Matthew is written from a Jewish point of view, Matthew will calculate time the Jewish way, something that we'll need to remember in order to avoid getting confused. Therefore, in dealing with the days for the rest of the book, we're going to refer to the Jewish time first and then translate that into our time. So after finishing his sayings, Jesus told the disciples that after 2 days is the Passover and the Son of Man will be crucified and slain. Now there's a point we need to take note of. The Passover also coincided with the Feast of Unleavened Bread, and since they occurred at the same time, the Passover is a term used to describe both, which is what Luke 22 verse 1 would confirm. The Jews were required to remove all leaven from their houses during this feast and would have done so the day before the feast. Let's keep those thoughts in the back of our minds as we continue through this chapter. Jesus and his disciples are sitting on the Mount of Olives, and he tells them that after 2 days is the Passover. What day are we talking about? For the Jews, this would be the beginning of the 4th day of the week, since, as we'll see later, the Passover took place on the 6th day of the week that year. What day would this be for us? It would be Tuesday after sunset. So as we said earlier, the Passover was in 2 days, and during that time, the Son of Man would be killed. Jesus had 3 previous times told the disciples that he was going to die. It would be very general at first and then get more specific, where in Matthew 20:18, he told them that this death would occur while they were in Jerusalem. With this last announcement, he gives them the exact date, 2 days from then. It is important that Jesus died during the Passover, for 1 Corinthians 5 verse 7, the Apostle Paul referred to Jesus as our Passover. It would be a rather weak reference that if Jesus died another time. During the time period between Jesus speaking these words and the night he sat down for his final meal, we find the chief priests, scribes, and elders plotting together as to how they would kill Jesus. This most likely occurred during the 5th day of the week, what we would call Wednesday, as this would have been only 1 day after Jesus' fiery rebukes found in chapters 21, 22, and 23. They were assembled at the place of Caiaphas, who we find out is the high priest. They knew that they couldn't take him while he was in a crowd, for there would be a riot. They knew that they couldn't take him during the feast, meaning the Passover would be eaten, for the exact same reason. So they were going to try and take him by trickery or quietly take him by surprise. Their goal would be to have him dead before any of the public knew it. Little did they know that one of Jesus' own disciples would soon come to them and assist them in their plan. With that, our time is up for today. Lord willing, we hope you'll join us for tomorrow's discussion in Matthew 26, verses 6 to 13, as we continue our walk through the Bible, one verse at a time.
I'm not a...
Thank you for watching today's episode. We hope that you found it edifying and ask that you not only subscribe to our channel and podcast, but that you like and share this episode among your friends so that the saving gospel of Jesus Christ can go out to the whole world.
Of his cross.